Good afternoon. Thank you so much for checking out another one of my videos. Today is going to be a new project panning challenge introduction, and I'm super excited to be sharing it with you all. I've actually picked out these products for about a week now, and I've been working on them, but I just haven't had the time to film. So I'm super excited to share with you. I'm going to be doing the Finish 9 by New Year's Project Panning Challenge. I have done one other challenge like this on my YouTube channel. I can link it above in the cards over here. It was a Finish 5 by Fall challenge, and it was a lot of fun. I enjoy having these kind of challenges to not only challenge myself to finish up products, but also to give myself that extra push and that nudge that I need, because a lot of times when products start to look used up, I'm like, oh, well, I don't want to run out. But it's just dumb because they need to be finished and I need to buy new ones because makeup doesn't last forever. So that's why I really enjoy doing these project panning challenges. So yeah, let's just dive right into the products. I've picked out 9 products that I want to either pan or finish before New Year's, before this little guy gets here, because he's due on New Year's Eve. So let's dive into it. Okay, this is going in no particular order, but I have a face product that I want to finish, and this is the Coty Airspun Loose Face Powder in Naturally Neutral. And I've had this, goodness, the reason I'm bringing this in is because I think I've had this for like 4 years. I had this before I got married, so it's got to be at least 4 years. And I'm getting close to being finished, and I feel like at this point I really just need to finish it and be done with it. I put a little sticker right here, which is where we are at. I kind of shake it down and put the sticker on it, and that's just kind of how I'm going to keep track. I think I'm going to take the sticker off and actually put a marker there, because I feel like my daughter will probably take the sticker off when I'm not looking, and then anyway, it's more than halfway done. There's not a whole lot left. I like to use this to set my whole face, or if I feel like baking, this is what I go to, but it's getting old, and I just need to buy a new one, and I need to finish this up. So I'm putting it in this project pan because I would like to have this completely done by New Year's. The next powder that I want to finish completely by New Year's is Rimmel Stay Matte Long Lasting Pressed Powder. This is not the first pan that I've gone through, but this is just one of my favorite pressed powders, and when it starts to show the rim, the pan like it is now, I just get lazy and I choose other powders over it, and I need to just finish it up so that I can get a brand new one and start on that, because that's fun. So I am putting this into my project pan, and hopefully I shouldn't have any problems finishing this up by New Year's. I use this specifically for my under eyes, but I will also set my whole face some days. So the next product that I don't specifically want to finish, but I do want to hit pan on, is the Revlon PhotoReady number 100 Bronzing Chic bronzing powder, and this has been discontinued for a long time. I went through and decluttered all my makeup, which I will should be around now starting to share with y'all. I did a massive declutter, and I did save this one because I really do like the formula, but knowing that it's, you know, getting older and knowing that it's discontinued, I just don't reach for it, and that's just dumb. So I want to commit to using this until New Year's, and that way I can, one, see how I like it, if it's worth keeping in my collection. I've been using it for a good solid week, and I really do like what it gives me. I have it on today. It's really easy just to swirl my brush in there, or, you know, go in specifically if I want to target more deeper or lighter shades. But anyway, I just want to use it consistently till New Year's. That way I can see if I like it and if I want to continue keeping it in my collection. And I feel like I should be able to hit pan if I use this every day until New Year's, but we shall see. I've got a significant dip in this corner of the palette, so it looks like when I first bought it, I really enjoyed these two colors. But now I've just kind of been swirling it all together, so I don't know. This one might be kind of tough just because I haven't really spent a whole lot of time with it since I bought it, but it's getting old. I want to get some use out of it, so I'm going to try my best to hit pan at least a little bit by New Year's Eve. Another product that I just want to hit pan on is the NYX blush. This is for the sole purpose that is just getting old. This is a discontinued blush. I've had it in a previous project pan on that when I did it on my blog that I tried to pan, and I didn't even hit pan on it. So for this challenge, I just want to hit pan. I just want to see some pan because I've been using this for years. It's a really beautiful blush. It's in Dusty Rose. I really enjoy it, but I feel like the formula might be starting to go, or it's just not as pigmented as I remember it being, so I feel like it might be starting to get bad. So I like to commit to using it till New Year's and see if I can hit pan on it, and then once New Year's hit, I'll decide if I want to keep on using it till it's done, or just call it done and get rid of it from my collection. But yeah, this is one that I really do want to hit pan on. Next up, I have a concealer, and this one you can't really, it's really hard to show you my progress, but as you can see, I've used a ton of it and there isn't a whole lot left, so I really just want to finish it up and, you know, be done with it. So that is why I'm sticking it in this project pan. It's one of those brush-ons, so you just kind of squeeze up as you go. I just would like to have it finished by New Year's, so yeah, this is the next one in the list. Okay, next up is not something I want to finish and not something I can pan, but this is the Rimmel Scandalize Waterproof Kohl Cajole Liner in black, and I would like to just commit to using it until New Year's when I want a black and just see how much I can use of this. I did go ahead and mark this on a little piece of paper that I have to put somewhere safe because right now I can't find it, so that's not safe, but I did mark how tall it is so that next time or at the end of the year I can see how much product I've actually used up. But this I use specifically just in my waterline. So I would be shocked if I finished this all, but I do want to commit to using it and seeing how much I can use up of this product by New Year's. All right, next up is a lip product, and I am wearing it today just to show you the color, but it is from Bite Beauty, and it is their High Pigment Lip Pencil in Sable. This came out a couple years ago. I purchased this a couple years ago for a holiday collection. They no longer carry this line. From what I understand, this High Pigment Pencil, they've reformulated it. So it's just getting old and I need to use it up. So this is how tall. I've also marked this on that little piece of paper that I need to find and put in safekeeping. But this is how much I have left. So I feel like I shouldn't have a problem using this up by New Year's, but we shall see. It's a really beautiful color, great for every day, so that's why I should be able to use this up by New Year's and then just be able to enjoy it before it goes bad. Okay, the next two products are actually in a little bottle. They're liquid. This is a setting spray that I got in my BoxyCharm a couple months ago. I'll link it above. But this is how much I have left of it. This is like the worst facial misting spray I've ever experienced because the product itself I think is really good. It is like hairspray when you use it on your face. So it's a nice product. I mean, I've used a ton of it up, but I just hate how it sprays. I feel like I just sprayed myself in the face with a hose. It's just, I don't like it. But I'm going to try to finish it up. As I said, I put a sticker there, but I'm going to get a black Sharpie marker so that I don't lose my spot if my daughter gets a hold of it. And then the last product that I want to finish up by New Year's is a perfume. And I am so bad at using perfumes. I just forget to apply them. So I want to start putting perfumes into these project panning challenges so that I remember to use them. But it is from Avon and it is their Eau de Parfum Spray in Bond Girl 007 Forever. And this was a scent like that I wore all the time as a teenager. So it brings back a lot of memories. I don't have much left. There's the line. That's what I'm going to try to use up by New Year's Eve. All right, so those are all the products that I'm going to try to use up. I really hope that I do better at this challenge than I did the last challenge. I feel a lot more confident in my goals for this challenge because I'm not exactly trying to complete these products. I just want to see some pan. So I feel like that'll be exciting if I finally do see that pan. Let me know if you'd like to see an update on this challenge. For my previous project panning challenges, I never did any kind of update in the middle. I just showed you what I was trying to pan when I started the challenge, and then I showed you the results. But if you would like to see like maybe a month by month basis, so like in a month I can share where I am, if I've made any progress, yada yada, let me know that below because that would be helpful. But if not, I'll probably just share with you guys my wrap up of this post in the new year, which might be in the middle of January, depending on when I have this baby. And if you're doing this project pan, finish 9 by New Year's challenge, definitely let me know down below so I can either go over and watch your video, or if you are just doing this on your own, leave your products that you're trying to pan in the comments down below. I'd love to hear what you're trying to complete by New Year's. I think doing these project pannings together is just so much fun, and having these little shorter challenges is a lot, very motivating and a lot of fun. And I've really been enjoying the Facebook project panning community that I recently became a part of, and they're just fantastic, and it's very motivating to see everyone, what products they're trying to use up and whatnot. So yeah, anyway, that's about all I have for this video. Thank you so much for watching again, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.